Hi, and welcome back to my Open BIM with Revit video series. Today, we'll be having a look at the levels and what we need to consider before exporting a Revit project to IFC. In Revit, we usually have many reference levels which don't represent the building structure, but actually only serve us as a reference for objects. To show you this, I will open the Golden Nugget sample project, which you can find in your Revit sample files if you have installed the German content. Otherwise, I also include a link to this project in the video description so you can also download it independently from the German content. Now, this project is a lot more complex than the other Revit sample files, and we can see the importance of good level management much better. The best way to review the levels is by switching to a section view. As you can see here, we have way too many levels which really don't have anything to do with the building stories, but are there only for reference inside of Revit. When you select a level and check its properties, you can find two properties which are important for the IFC export: the building story and the story above. Now let's have a look how these properties work. For this, we will switch to a more simple project, which will allow us to change the settings and check how they influence the export more quickly. The building story defines whether this level will be exported to IFC at all. Tick the box if you want to include this level in your IFC file and untick it to ignore it. In this case, all the elements which are now assigned to this level in Revit will be assigned to the next building story. Revit will usually take the next lower building story unless there is no lower story. In this case, it will assign elements to the next upper building story. You should always take care to select your building stories so that they make sense for your project, and of course, you should always have at least one building story in your model, otherwise your IFC file will be completely unstructured. A second option relevant for the IFC export is the property level above, and it is tied to another option which you will find in the export settings and which lets you split your walls, columns, and ducts by levels. This is relevant whenever you have one of these elements crossing multiple levels and need to split these when exporting. Usually these elements will be split by every building story, however, using the property level above, you can specify which levels will really be used for splitting. Let me show you this in detail. First, we'll define the level above as seen from the level our wall is actually assigned to. I'll switch from the standard to skip the level 1 and select level 3 in our case. After the export, we will see that the wall has been split at level 3 and also at all the following levels. Now we could go ahead and change the level above property for the level 3 and select level 5 instead. After the export, you can see that our wall has only been cut at level 3 and level 5, but not at level 4 anymore. This is very useful to know if you ever need to split the elements when exporting. As mentioned, currently this is only supported for walls, columns, and ducts. Last but not least, to repeat something we already learned in the previous video, we can also assign different names to our levels in IFC using the property IFC name. If you don't have this property in your project, you can easily add it. We had a closer look at this in the previous video. Here you can assign completely new names to your IFC levels without changing the names of your actual Revit levels. There is no need to activate any special option when exporting. These properties will be mapped automatically. I hope you have learned something new about Revit levels and IFC in this video. In the next video, we'll be having a look at the probably most important IFC topic, which are the common property sets. Until then, thanks for watching and don't forget to subscribe.